In this video, I go over the pros and the cons of the FIRE movement. In the FIRE movement, you get to live for free for the rest of your life, which means that you don't have to work anymore. If living for free entices you, then keep watching. You should watch until the end because by the end of this video, you'll know the pros and cons of the FIRE movement and whether or not it's for you. Only a small percentage of my viewers are actually subscribed to my channel, so please hit the subscribe button below. It's free for you to do, and you could always unsubscribe later. If you join the FIRE movement, then you'll have unlimited money. Unlimited money, which means you're rich, and if this sounds like a scam, it's not, because these are actually facts. The people in the FIRE community don't have to work anymore because they have enough money to last for eternity. They're ballin. They live off of the money that their income generates. So think of your dollar as a little worker ant, and you have a whole bunch of dollars that are your worker ants, and you're the queen ant or king ant. This is due to something that is called the 4% rule, which is also known as the safe withdrawal rate. You could live off of 4% of your investment portfolio for the rest of your life and not run out of money, which means that you have unlimited money. You'll never have to work again, you'll never be poor again, and all of your expenses are completely covered. The next pro to the FIRE community is that you'll finally be free. You'll finally have freedom, freedom to do whatever it is that you actually want to do. Time is money, and since you now have unlimited money, you finally have all the time and you could do whatever you want to do, whatever your little heart desires. Let's say you hate your job, you have like a horrible boss and you want to quit your job. If you join the FIRE community and you reach financial independence, then you could quit your job because you don't have to worry about money, you're financially stable. Or maybe you don't like the city or town that you live in, you can move out. You could move out of that city, you could go to another city, or you could even travel the world. You could spend your time however which way you please. Maybe you have really cool hobbies. Maybe you like rock climbing at exotic locations. You could do that if you are in the FIRE community and you reach financial independence. Or maybe you're like me and all you want to do is Netflix and chill. You could do that too, because you have all the time in the world to do that. You could also spend time with your family and loved ones. Now, this is a big thing in the FIRE community because a lot of parents, they work 9-to-5 jobs that keeps them away from their kids, right? And I know a lot of parents who can't spend that much time with their kids. So imagine if you didn't have to work anymore and you could spend your 9-to-5 hours at home watching your kids grow, or you know, spending holidays with your family. That right there, I think that's priceless. The next pro to the FIRE community is that there are different types of FIRE. Even though the RE part of FIRE stands for retire early, you actually don't need to ever retire if you don't want to. You could keep working, you could do whatever your heart desires. FIRE is highly customizable. For instance, there is Coast FIRE, and in Coast FIRE, you have enough money invested to cover the traditional retirement at the ripe, young, age of 65 years old. You don't have to invest any more money into the stock market. You don't have to save any more money at all. You could live off of 100% of your income because at 65 years old, you don't have to worry about retiring anymore. You're good to go. However, this is where things get good because what if you don't want a traditional retirement? What if you want to be balling in money, driving Lambos, living in mansions on the beach? Well, you could do that with Fat FIRE. Fat FIRE is the most luxurious one out of the entire FIRE community because these are people who want to live a lavish lifestyle and spend a lot of money without working ever again. So if you do want to live in a mansion and drive Lambos all day, then Fat FIRE is for you. The FIRE movement definitions are not strict, they're not cookie cutter. You could adjust it however which way your heart desires so that it fits you and the lifestyle that you want. However, although the FIRE community seems like a dream, there are a lot of cons with the FIRE community. And even though the pros sound really good, you should keep watching so that you learn about the negatives. A big con to the FIRE community is that you might run out of money. Now, I know I said that you'll have unlimited money once you reach financial independence. However, there's still a chance that you'll go broke. You might run out of money due to major life changes or unexpected emergencies. What if something unexpected happens? For instance, what if you get divorced? You plan to reach financial independence with your spouse, and then 10, 20 years down the line, you guys get divorced, and then you'll have to work again. Or what if you end up having more children than you have originally planned? Raising a child is not cheap, and this will definitely change how much money you need in order to reach FIRE. You might have unexpected medical bills that are really expensive. You might even get sued. I mean, if it happened to the best of us, it could happen to all of us. Something could happen that'll drain you of all of your money. And since you'll be older, and since you were retired and you haven't worked in a while, it'll definitely be harder to try to work again. The next con to the FIRE movement, and I want to say this con is the reason why most people will never do FIRE, is because FIRE, it takes a lot of sacrifice. For instance, if you want to do FIRE, then you have to budget. And I believe everyone should budget, not just those people in the FIRE community, but those in the community take budgeting to the next level because they budget so much to the point where they only live off of a small fraction of their income. One of the core teachings in the FIRE movement is to live off of a small fraction of your income and to save as much money as possible. You need to live off of less than what you make because your savings rate determines when you could actually retire. Here's a helpful chart of when you could retire depending on how much money you save. And if you wanted to retire in 19 years, then you would have to save 45% of your income. And if you wanted to retire in 7 years, then you would have to save 75% of your income. 75% of your income is a huge portion of your paycheck, and it takes a lot of sacrifice in order to do that. There's also the argument that you sacrifice the best years of your life. You know, people who reach FIRE, they work 10, 15 years at a job they hate so that they could ultimately retire early. But would it be better to work a job that you don't hate, to work a job you're passionate about until you're 65 and retire then? And even if you love your job, in order to reach the high savings rate, you need to make a lot of sacrifices in your budget. For example, with me, I budget every month so that I have a high savings rate, and in order to do that, I often have to turn down invites from my friends to go out. I often turn down invites from my friends because it was out of my budget, even though I could afford to go out with them. And part of me feels as if I'm missing out on living the best years of my life. Let me know your thoughts in the comments below. I can't be the only one who feels this way. The next con of the FIRE community is that there's just too much stress on saving money. The FIRE movement stresses too much on saving money instead of making money. The quote goes, "It's not about how much you make, it's how much you save." And I completely agree with this. There are a lot of doctors, lawyers, high earners that never become millionaires because they're too busy spending all of their money and living a really expensive lifestyle. They spend what they make, and because of that, they never build their wealth. Even though they're making $150,000 a year, they're spending $150,000 a year, so their net worth still remains the same. If you take a look on the statistics on millionaires, about one third of them never made $100,000 in any given year. This statistic was taken from the Dave Ramsey website, and in my next video, I go over why I do not follow Dave Ramsey anymore. Make sure to subscribe and hit the notification bell because the video is a spicy one and you don't want to miss it. The FIRE community stresses that savings is the most important factor in retiring early. And if you look at the savings chart, savings is very helpful. However, what if you increased your income? What if you focused all your efforts into increasing your income? You could double your income or even triple your income, and then you could hit FIRE even earlier than you have originally planned. Or you could maintain the same savings rate and still retire in an X amount of years. Now, this is kind of like having your cake and eating it too. There is no cap to how much money you could make. You could make $1 million a year, $10 million a year, right? However, there is a cap to how much money you can save. And this is because you could only reduce your living expenses by so much. If you want to learn more about the FIRE movement, I have linked a FIRE movement playlist down below. Make sure to check that out. Make sure to subscribe and hit the notification bell so that you are notified of future videos. And make sure to watch this video next. And with that, thanks for watching, and I will see you guys in the next video. Bye.